What you're looking at is the base of this is what I call the cloud. The cloud actually anchors these clusters of LEDs called mandalas. They also contain microphones. So when we go up to them and you can speak into it a sentence, my future looks, my future is, my future looks interesting. And she turns that into a whole array of patterns that are very specific based on your emotion, your palette, voice. And these colors actually go into that central sculpture to become part of the collective.
There is like 3 to 4 machine learning technologies, let alone like another 10, 12 cloud technologies that are all running in harmony to create this effect.
The engineer in me, I'm very fascinated to know how you mixed art and design and industrial engineering. What did it take to build this?
Of course, as an artist, I start with like no real knowledge of how artificial intelligence can actually work, right? So my idea starts like as a drawing on paper. It became this incredibly interesting dialogue with technology. Like to work with your team and to work with my coding team and to really look at how can we take voice, turn it into light, turn that light into these mandalas that are unique and specific.
By the way, I never heard an artist say they have a coding team until today. So that itself is fascinating on its own.
My experience, honestly, working with it and working with your team, I truly felt like I was watching magic. You know, there is that element, right? Because it's creating something that's coming from a desire to know more, which I think is basically human, but to also put what we all know together all the time and moving us more and more towards our collective abilities. So Swami, this is such a huge field that you're such a luminary in. How do you see it as being a force in our society? How do you see machine learning being this vehicle that carries us forward?
Machine learning is still, I would put it, it's in its infancy. It's almost like if I were to put it in human terms, it's probably, I would see it as like a toddler age, so to speak. I hope when we look back 50 years from now, you're going to see machine learning to be like as pervasive as the cloud or the computers or hopefully even the electricity is.
It's so appropriate then that the sculpture is right where electricity also debuted here. It's so interesting that you say that it's in its infancy, you know, because I felt like AI and ML was already around us, but we hadn't been actually very conscious about it. So how do you see machine learning growing?
By putting it in the hands of all builders of all kinds, if we make it accessible, is to make sure they know how to use it in a responsible fashion as well. If you were recommending a movie, you probably don't worry so much. But if you're going to use it, let's say, to assist a radiologist about spotting anomalies, then you don't want the machine learning system to automatically come to a decision.
And particularly as our problems get more complex in the world. We need a tool that's as powerful as that, I think, right? I've grown increasingly interested in this hybrid physical-digital space, coming from a purely physical, feeling-based practice into really thinking about a world that can hold both in equal parts, where one is influencing the other, is fascinating to me. I can't wait, actually. I'm waiting for the next thing to do.
My future looks happy.